The Philippine government's debt service bill doubled in August. Treasury Bureau data show it reached 186.2 billion pesos in August, up 130% from July's 81.2 billion pesos. This increase is largely due to amortization on domestic debt, which surged to 122 billion pesos in August, compared to just 185 million pesos in July. Logistics firm Lala Move offers work opportunities for jeepney drivers at risk of displacement due to the PUV modernization program. Let's get the details of that story with Andrea Taguines. Hi, Andy.
Hi, Denise. On-demand delivery platform Lala Move just launched this Thursday morning the Metro Manila leg of its Tuloy Biyahe program in Quezon City. The initiative aims to employ thousands of jeepney drivers that may be displaced because they failed to join or were unfortunately were not able to keep up with the requirements of the government's public transport modernization program. Of course, it's also open to everyone who wants to earn a little extra income. With Lala Move, organizers said aspiring partner drivers can be flexible with their time or choose when to accept orders, making it the perfect side gig. And if they don't have their own vehicle, Chupair Onboarding Roadshow offers car loan options, or they can be matched with a Lala Move verified fleet operator who needs drivers for their registered vehicles. Other benefits include fuel discounts and free vehicle maintenance. According to Lala Move Philippines Managing Director John Nacario, this is also one of the ways the logistics company is beefing up its fleet in preparation for the holiday season rush. That's as he expects the demand for deliveries to increase by 30% this Christmas compared to last year.
Very critical po sa atin ng Christmas season dahil po marami sa ating mga mamamayan ang nangangailangan ng delivery solutions. So masasabi po natin na isa ito sa mga preparatory stages po to make sure that we are able to support the Christmas rush. Even as early as now, nakikita na namin na nagsisimula siya dahil yung Christmas po ay nagsisimula ng September sa Pilipinas eh.
Denise, last week, Lala Move also held the roadshow in several cities in northern and central Luzon, which was attended by 2,000 aspiring partner drivers. After the one in Quezon City, they're set to visit Valenzuela City next, Lipa City in Batangas, and Cebu in October. Back to you, Denise.
Andrea Taguines with that report. Thanks, Andy. Grab says it is putting 10,000 more cars on Philippine roads in the lead up to the Christmas season, when it typically sees a surge in demand. The local unit of Southeast Asia's largest ride-hailing and delivery firm is also optimistic. Next year is probably the year it will finally get to profitability.
Work on supply, as always, and we've worked with the regulator to release new cars into the market. The first tranche of 5,000 cars is on the way, and we are expecting potentially another 5,000 for the holidays. We are not even approaching, you know, what we were in 2019. So maybe with the next 5 or 10,000 cars, we will reach, I think, pre-pandemic levels. It's been a difficult journey to get back kind of the supply coming from the pandemic, because we, if people don't remember, GrabCar was closed down for most of 2020. And so a lot of the cars of people, you know, were lost. And we've had to build up that fleet.
The new presiding chief of the Philippine Energy Regulatory Commission asks the public to give him a year to bring down power rates in the country. Alvin El Chico reports.
The officer in charge, appointed by Malacañang in the Energy Regulatory Commission, targets to bring down electricity prices soon. Lawyer Jesse Andres immediately met with ERC commissioners and directors on his first day in office Wednesday to communicate the president's marching order.
Kailangan natin ng maraming intervention para bumaba ang presyo ng kuryente. At lahat po ng stakeholders kailangan magtulong-tulong, magkaroon ng kooperasyon. Even ang namumuhunan, ang mga electric cooperatives, ang mga power producers, kailangan to give and take.
Andres was appointed OIC after the six-month preventive suspension of ERC Chairperson Mona Lisa Dimalanta. Andres says his first objective is to speed up various processes in the commission, which is plagued by thousands of case backlogs.
With more competition, we can be assured that prices will go down. But if the processing of documents ay mabagal, hindi po maaprobahan ang mga bagong proyekto, ang paglago ng kompetisyon na kailangan-kailangan para bumaba ang presyo.
ABS-CBN sources claim, aside from Meralco's rate hike, the commission, prior to the entry of Andres, had already ruled on the petition to grant the increase in the rate of the National Grid Corporation. ERC Commissioner Catherine Maceda refuses to confirm the NGCP rate hike, but says the commission will release its initial determination in the next weeks. Maceda encourages the public to comment on it.
Hinihikayat ko po ang publiko na makilahok at magbigay ng kanilang mga komento at opinyon. Ipo-post po namin yung aming tinatawag na initial determination ng transmission rates. Kayo po'y magkomento.
Meanwhile, when asked how is he going to deal with big-time and influential tycoons who have interests in generation, transmission, and distribution of electricity, Andres says he will stand his ground.
I have been known to be a fair and independent man, and I will continue to be so. Tayo ho ay magiging patas sa lahat. Gagawin po natin ang tama para sa mga namumuhunan at lalong-lalo na para sa taong bayan na humihiling ng mas mababang presyo ng kuryente.
The OIC asked for a one-year period to realize his goal of bringing down electricity rates in the country. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine central bankers could cut key rate by 25 basis points at their October 17 meeting and by another 25 basis points at their December 19 meeting. This was revealed by BSP Governor Eli Remolona himself on the sidelines of an Asian Development Bank forum Wednesday. Remolona points to easing inflation for the forecast. Philippine consumer prices slowed to a seven-month low in August. And during the same month, the Monetary Board reduced the BSP's benchmark rate by 25 basis points to 6.25%. That's the first rate cut in nearly 4 years.
The Marcos administration's multi-party alliance finally revealing its senatorial lineup for the 2025 midterm polls. Interior Chief Benhur Abalos was the first candidate to be announced by President Marcos. Five incumbent senators are also seeking re-election under the Bagong Pilipinas Alliance banner. These include Senators Bong Revilla, Francis Tolentino Lito Lapid, Pia Cayetano, and the President's sister Aimee Marcos. Three former senators, including former Senate President Tito Soto, will also be attempting to return to the upper chamber. Completing the administration slate, Makati Mayor Abby Binay, House Lawmaker Camille Villar, and ACT CIS Party List Representative Erwin Tu. The accomplishments and experiences will greatly contribute to the country.
Napagsuwang magigiting na Pilipino na may taglay na sipag at galing para maging pinuno. Tangan ang prinsipyong makatao, makadiyos, makabansa. Titindig para sa interes ng bayan at sa kapakanan at karapatan ng bawat isang Pilipino. Sa aking pag-endorso, ang tanging hiling ko ay mapanatili ang kanilang katapatan at pagmamahal sa bansa. Ito ang pinakamahalagang katangian ng kandidato na aking tinitignan at pinag-iisipan. Sila ay ating magiging katuwang sa ating pagsulong at sa patuloy na pag-unlad ng ating bansa. Atin po sila ay samahan at suportahan.
Marcos started forming the Alianza para sa Bagong Pilipinas last May as a continuation of his unity campaign. The alliance is composed of five major political parties, including the President's Partido Federal ng Pilipinas and Martin Romualdez led Lakas CMD.
Ang sabi nila, ang halalan daw ay panahon ng pagkakabitak-bitak, pagsisiraan, pagkakahati-hati. Subalit, kabaliktaran po ang inululunsad ng ating alyansa. Sapagkat ito ay isang kilusang bayan na magbubuklod sa pinakamalawak na puwersa ng mga nagmamahal sa inang bayan, na ikakampanya ang isang programang pangkaunlaran.
Unity is crucial. Each of our parties, whether it be Partido Federal ng Pilipinas, Lakas CND, the National People's Coalition, and the National Lista Party, or the National Unity Party, represents different perspectives, histories, and stories. But today, we come together not as separate groups, but as one force for the people. We stand united because we know that in unity we find the power to turn our dreams into reality.
Philippine lawmaker Johnny Pimentel standing by the credibility of former Education Undersecretary Gloria Mercado amid her allegations and revelations against Vice President Sara Duterte. Mercado earlier revealed she received 50,000 pesos from Duterte every month on top of her salary, which she believes was intended to influence her decisions as head of the DepEd's procurement group. The vice president denied the allegations, challenging Mercado to present documents to prove her claim. Pimentel adds more individuals are willing to step forward to shed light on the matter.
Bukas nga, meron na naman kaming bagong resource person, dalawa. So, actually, marami ho ang nagbo-volunteer, pero yung iba nasa active service pa, they do not want to come out. Pero nakakatugma-tugma naman yung mga sinasabi nila sa amin. And these two persons, nag-under oath na.
Former Philippine Senator Antonio Trillanes believes Vice President Sara Duterte is bound for impeachment. Trillanes denied Duterte's claims he and other opposition lawmakers are being controlled by what she calls a political handler. He also believes Duterte is trying to convince the public officials are conspiring to impeach her. But the former senator says it's only a matter of time before Duterte is removed from office, as lawmakers are currently investigating her alleged misuse of public funds.
Vice President Sara Duterte is just bluffing. She's used to doing or saying these things, but she doesn't have anything. Okay, I dare her to show anything that she has. But believe me, within the next week or two, she won't be able to show anything. It's just like the Polvoron videos that they've been teasing the whole country. And in the end, they just came up with an AI video.
The International Monetary Fund seeks greater efforts to ensure economic stability amid global headwinds. This appeal made by IMF Chief Kristalina Georgieva in the lender's annual report. She called for multilateral cooperation to prevent further geopolitical shocks as well as fiscal adjustments and to continue bringing down inflation. All these, as Georgieva described, as turbulent the global economy after the pandemic as a result of wars and tighter monetary policies. The IMF chief also says nations must work to tackle trends that affect the world, from climate change, digitalization, and artificial intelligence. The Bulgarian economist who secured a second term as leader of the IMF vowed they will be responsive to the member countries' needs while looking well into the future. Israel preparing for possible ground operations into Lebanon. Israel's military chief says the airstrikes are continuing in order to destroy Hezbollah infrastructure and clear the way for a possible ground incursion. Lebanon's health minister says at least 51 were killed and 223 wounded as Israel widened its airstrikes Wednesday. He also estimates the number of displaced in the hundreds of thousands. Israel, meanwhile, reports shooting down a missile near Tel Aviv. Hezbollah claims to have targeted Israel's spy agency with a ballistic missile in a further escalation of the nearly year-long conflict. Despite growing tensions in Lebanon, this Filipino worker says towering bills are forcing her to stay and simply hope for the best.
I was really thinking, my boss already told me if you want to go, you can go anytime. they are trying to enforce me to go home, but I choose to stay because, you know, going back home in the Philippines is kind of, it's a matter of thinking for the future. And, you know, 30,000 pesos is not easy to find in the Philippines. And right now, okay, the government are offering money, but that's not enough, especially I have some responsibilities.
The United States, France, and several allies called for an immediate 21-day ceasefire across the Israel-Lebanon border, while also expressing support for a ceasefire in Gaza following intense discussions at the United Nations on Wednesday.